Hello friends, welcome to the code sample. In code sample, you can easily learn the complex coding task. Before we continue, if you have not subscribed code sample, please do subscribe and turn on the bell icon so you get the instant update of my latest videos. In this video, I am going to show how can create a dynamic PDF file from an HTML resource in the ASP.NET web application. Here I am creating a sample invoice including a logo in PDF format using ASP.NET and C#. First of all, we need some NuGet libraries. Number two, write a web service to generate PDF files from the HTML resources. Number three, write an AJAX method to execute or call the web service. And finally, generate the PDF file. So, open the Visual Studio and create a new ASP.NET web application project. Select ASP.NET web application. Write the project name. Say PDF report sample. Click on OK button. Select empty template. Check web form. Click on OK button. First of all, we add a new waveform in our project. I have already created an HTML file for the HTML resource, one CSS file and one logo for the sample invoice. So before continue, I will import all the resources into our project. I am creating some folders to store all the resources individually. Add the HTML file which we already prepared. This is the sample HTML file which I have already prepared for this project. Now import the other resources like the CSS file and the logo. Add the CSS file.
set the paper size in the CSS. Import the logo. This is the basic output of our HTML resource. Now add the references from NuGet package manager. We are using itext 7 and itext 7.pdf html reference in our project. Install both libraries. Now these assemblies are added into our project. Now create a model class. Add a web service into the project.
So click on add new item. And select web service, that is ASMX file. ASMX provides the ability to build web services that send messages using the simple object access protocol, that is SOAP. ASMX file is used to add web services logic to the methods visible by the client application, and it acts as the base URL for clients calling the XML web service. Uncomment this line. Add references for the model class and itex7 library. Now create a method and a web method to generate a PDF file from a user-defined or dynamic HTML resource. Now assign the HTML source in the web method. Copy the complete HTML code from the sample HTML file. Before we put the HTML source in the web method, we have to minify the HTML source. Go to google.com and search for HTML minifier. There are so many HTML minifier found in the Google. Click one of them and minify the HTML source. Copy the minified HTML. And paste it in the web method. Once we paste the HTML source, there are so many errors. This is because due to the double quotation in the HTML source. I am going to replace all the double quotation from the HTML source. Open Notepad editor and replace all the double quotations with single quotation. Copy the modified HTML source and paste it in the web method. This time, no more errors. There are so many methods to assigning the HTML source in the web method. You can read a HTML file and store it in a variable, or it may be create from database. Add another folder to store the PDF files. Define the file path. We define a dynamic file name. Now call the PDF report function to generate the PDF file. There are three parameters in this function. Number one, the base URL. It is required for external resources like CSS, images, etc. Number two, a HTML resource. And number three, a file name. If the function return a value is greater than 0, then the web method returns the path of the generated PDF file. Now open the web form and create an Ajax method to call the web service. Before writing the Ajax method, define the jQuery library references from CDN. Go to Google and search for jQuery CDN. Open jQuery official site. And copy the reference for jQuery Minifier library. Paste the reference in the head section. jQuery is a JavaScript library designed to simplify HTML DOM tree traversal and manipulation, as well as event handling, CSS animation, and Ajax. It's totally free and open source. Add a button in the webform. Now write a AJAX method to call the web service. We create a click event for the button. The AJAX method
is more or less complete. Now we will add a class for click event listener to the button. Run the project. Click the button to generate the PDF file. So finally, the PDF file generated from the HTML resources, but the logo is not displayed and our CSS is not working. So copy the base URL paste the base URL in the function, save the project and run it once again. Click the button. So this is our final PDF report. The set base URL property in ITX 7 is responsible for the external resources like CSS and images. That's why after commenting on that line, the external CSS and image is not working in our report. Uncomment the line and run the project once again. Now all the external resources are working properly. In this way, we can easily generate a PDF file from an HTML resource. In another video, I will show how can generate a dynamic HTML resource. If you have any query, please write in the comment section. Thank you friends. Keep watching Code Sample.